In today's video, I'm going to be talking about raising our boys to become godly men. Obviously, as parents, we have a huge responsibility to mold and train our children to love the Lord, and then we're also relying on God to do work in their hearts to bring about salvation. And so I was thinking about some things that I'm specifically working on with my son as far as encouraging him to grow up to become a godly young man, hopefully like his daddy. So today I'm going to share with you five different things that I'm trying to instill in my son so that he can grow up to become a godly man. The first one is to be strong. I try to give my son little jobs to do around the house that require him to lift things that are, you know, not super heavy, but and just encourage him and say, "Wow, you are so strong. Thank you for helping mommy." You know, giving him maybe help me take out the trash or the recycling, maybe lift a light laundry basket or something like that. But just encouraging that that strength in him, that he would be a strong young man who uses his strength to help serve others. And the second thing is to be courageous. Obviously, God has designed the family in such a way that the husband is the leader of his family, and so I want to encourage my son to be courageous. So in little things, like even if there's a bug in the house, maybe there's a beetle that gets in, instead of him screaming and freaking out, my husband has trained him to get a plastic cup and trap the bug, slip a piece of paper underneath it, and then release it outside. So we're encouraging him, you know, you are this big, the bug is this big, I bet you can catch that bug and put it outside. Now obviously it's nothing, you know, dangerous or poisonous that we're asking him to catch, but just giving him little areas where he can overcome his little fears and be courageous. The next one is to be hardworking and diligent. We give all of our kids certain chores that they're responsible for around the house, and we encourage them to do it well. We don't just want them to do a half-hearted job that's sloppy. We want to train them to do their work well. And so if they're responsible for sweeping, then we'll do a double check after they're done. And if there's, you know, a ton of extra crumbs, then we encourage them, "Hey, you didn't do a very thorough job." We want to do our work excellent. We want to be diligent workers and hardworking and do the best that we can. And so encouraging my son to be a hard worker, to do his best, to give his best effort, will hopefully be a blessing to him as he grows up and becomes a provider for his family. The next one is to be respectful. And this has a lot of different ways that you can apply it. First of all, we want to be respectful of God and his authority as the creator of everything, and he made us. So first of all, we want to respect God. We also want to respect those that God has put in authority in our culture. So like our government leaders, our teachers, our pastors, you know, our police officers, things like that, people in authority. And then also we want to be respectful of our family, so our being respectful of our parents. And also teaching my son the importance of respecting women, making sure that he understands the appropriate way to treat young ladies. And so hopefully as he's growing into a young man, he will be blessed with a godly woman and he'll know how to treat her in a way that glorifies God. And the last one is self-control. And again, this can apply to lots of different areas. I want to teach my son self-control with his actions and controlling what he's doing. I want him to have self-control with his words and the things that he speaks. And I also want him to have self-control in his thoughts, the things that people can't see. But God knows our thoughts and he knows the intentions of our heart, and the importance of being aware of what we're putting into our minds and what we're allowing into our thoughts. That can have a great impact on the way that we behave and also the things that we're thinking of. The Bible says, out of the overflow of the heart, the mouth speaks. And so all those different areas, I'm hoping to teach him to have self-control. So those are just five of the areas that I'm trying to be really intentional in developing in my son so he can hopefully grow up to become a godly young man. And I'd love to hear from you guys. Are there certain character qualities that you're specifically working with your sons or with your daughters? I'd love for you to share them in the comments below. And thank you as always for watching, and I hope you all have a great day.